If you can send me an email of it, have it. Is it,
Whoa.
Can't you just hand it?
You can just plug it.
Is it on the website?
I'm gonna take this plug off.
Yeah.
Can't just.
Let me take you to the village's website.
Yes.
Yeah, if you need it.
To think of that, then I haven't thought of it.
That's what I have.
Yeah, clock's been off for quite a while. 720, I have 722.
721.
Yeah, no, I'm talking about the...
721 and a half.
In the back, once per hour.
All right, that's our official time.
722 by the time you do 22.
You think I'm that slow?
You don't want us to answer that, do you?
Do you want to answer that question?
No, not really.
Okay, could I have a motion to come back? Oh, sorry. Reversing.
Okay. So we only have 3 minutes.
Okay. Motion to come back. All right, can I have a motion to come back in open session?
Second.
Roll call.
Trustees Dermaski.
Aye.
Georgine Duberstein.
Aye.
Barrett.
Aye.
Hine.
Aye.
Daly.
Aye.
And George Duberstein.
Aye.
And this is at 7:24.
I turned on the head.
No action is being taken from executive session. However, we do have a correction from an earlier business item.
I move that the 9 cents an hour total of $138 and some cents raised for Roseanne Stark be retroactive to May 1st.
Second.
Roll call.
Trustees Dermaski.
Aye.
Georgianne Duberstein.
Aye.
Barrett.
Aye.
Hine.
Nay.
Daly.
Aye.
And George Duberstein.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Okay, motion to adjourn the regular board meeting.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Meeting adjourned at 7:24 and a half. Jerry, take care.
Thank you.
Bye.
Okay, we're going to roll right over in the committee of the whole, which will now come to order at 7:25. On Tuesday, July 26, 2016. Roll call.
Mayor Minnesota.
Still here.
Trustees Dermaski.
Here.
Georgianne Duberstein. Barrett.
Present.
Hine.
Here.
Daly is excused. And George Duberstein.
Aye.
We are in quorum. If I could have approval of the agenda.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Motion for omnibus?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, we will jump down to committee of the whole, starting with Public Works. Trustee George Duberstein.
What?
He's going to let me go first because
I...
Oh, you're pressed for time.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so we're going to switch the order and wetlands, open spaces, and woodlands with Georgian.
As I mentioned earlier, the Queen Anne's Lace that's in the easements along Hainesville Road by the meadow and also by Cranberry Lake will all be dealt with. They're gonna mow the area along Hainesville Road. They've been doing work according to the five-year plan, and that's on schedule. They'll also be mowing Deer Point, and that really takes some special mowing because we have a lot of little plants, and they have to go in and out to make sure that nothing happens to the little shrubs that are there. They put in wire logs. They're these big, I think they're made of coconut shell shreds last year, and it turns out that they installed them too high because now the water level is lower than the wire logs, and they need to be in water. And the purpose of them is to prevent the erosion that happens around the village pond. So Dave is going to have them lower the wire logs at his expense, and they're going to put in some more flower plugs. We do have some flowers that have germinated from the seeds that they put in and from the plugs, but they're going to do more. Other than that, they're keeping on schedule for the things that they need to do.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Georgia. Now we'll go to Trustee George Jurcisik on public works.
Okay, first thing is, I have a revised contract through our school services that's going to provide the transportation shuttle bus for the reenactment event. So I have a contact with me, somebody, either you or Kelly or both, or me.
Yeah, Kelly and I can go.
Okay, so I'll leave that with you. You can take care of that. We will have to revise the contract for the sanitation because we may need a few more porta potties to.
Oh, porta potties.
So it'll take a little.
Okay.
So I'll have to do that. I've been on the computer and on the phone with all kinds of people today with regard to the reenactment. I won't go through everything, but I did contact the, and I sent, for any emails I sent out, you have a copy, you have a copy, Roseanne's copy. I contacted the, quote, mayor, unquote, of the Sweetens, and she, there are about seven different people, and I, in that message I sent out, a list of everybody, and an attachment that you have. She will get with them to orchestrate what exactly they're going to do presentation-wise and what, and so we can put in the schedule. And I'm hoping to get the schedule for everything nailed down over the next 2 weeks so we can then go to the printers with that schedule for the program and some of the signage. I sent today that Kelly was kind enough to send me an email of the reservations for our Lincoln and Jefferson Davis people at the hotel. And I finally, since I was away all this week, I finally sent them the copies of what they need to have so that they know what's available for them. I talked with both of our food vendors today. They're on board and they'll be happy to provide service. One will is Luke's that you provided, and they're going to do just about everything with the exception of desserts. And then I have another funnel cake contact that I saw at the Wakanda reenactment a couple of weeks ago. And they're going to provide the funnel cakes, ice cream, basically, we have two vendors for food, and that's really all we need. Need to continue the kudos for Mike, who was kind enough to get with one of his friends in one of the villages, and we're going to have 30 picnic benches that we can use for our sit-downs for the food eating, and we'll pick those up probably Tuesday before and set it out there. So that will help a lot, so thank you very much. Let's see. guy that portrays General Grant, and he's going to have his whole headquarters and the staff and a working telegraph office, so that's another venue that we'll have there.
Awesome, that's exciting.
So,
And let's get that in detail for like the August newsletter, things like that, bring it up for the website and the newsletter, because we...
Just so everybody knows, here's some of the reenactors that we have on board right now. Obviously, President Mrs. Lincoln, we have somebody doing Jefferson Davis. We have this guy I just talked about doing General Grant. We have Dave Over, who's the executive director of Great Lake Heritage Center, is going to come in and do some of the local history and local attachment to Civil War activities for people in the area at that time. And I have a guy playing Elijah Haynes, found a village, and we also have the American cricket team that will be ongoing during the proceedings. And obviously, the 17th Corps Hospital will have their demonstration, medical demonstrations of a nature that was similar to what we had previously.
All right, George, just a quick comment. I was invited to have dinner with the Grace Lake Masons Lodge. Turns out that that lodge was started by Elijah Haynes, and they have got a extensive historical background on his business dealings and workings here. Next week, Sunday, I'm going to go to their pancake breakfasting with a friend of mine from the lodge, and I'll talk to their historian and see maybe if he could participate to add a little more background info to help you and whatever. Because they mentioned that what they'd like to do is come into the village board here and actually do a presentation on Elijah Haynes and the history of Hainesville from what they've recovered. They've actually located his grave site, which is over in Waukegan, almost up the lake, over in Lake Shore. These guys have got history that, they're starting to show me this stuff. I said, walk away, and he said, we'd love to come in and present to the village. So as we move forward, after you get done with your project with the reenactment, it might be worth our while just to have these gentlemen come in and talk to us at the board level, just so we all know a little bit more about Hainesville.
Yeah, that's great.
Better. Okay.
Yeah, that's great. In fact, if you want to, the flyer announcing this event that we have and some of the details are on the website. So if you want to download that and
print it out, absolutely.
I'll
get it to them. I'll find out. I mean, I just when you talk about these other actors coming, reenactors coming in, they're like, okay, maybe I'll talk to the Masons.
I don't know whether they would be involved in actually presenting at the event, but
there's some histories they could give to the actor.
To the actors, exactly.
That's what I was saying. But I wonder if they work with the Grace Lake Historical Society that also has information on Hainesville or
find out.
Because Dave Ober will be here.
Yeah. And there is Haines House in Waukegan. Yeah. You are aware of that. Yeah. Yeah. So that has a lot of that history there.
So I'll be in contact with them next week, Sunday, and have breakfast with my buddy Mario.
Okay, appreciate it.
Thank you, George.
All right, George, before we move on, is there anything else you need as far as assistance or volunteers or help from Public Works or staff?
I will need, obviously, the Public Works help.
Yeah, I mean, in addition to what's already been
filed. I don't know. We have an information booth and a program booth. The program's being out, that's being in. I was thinking, I haven't done it yet, but I was thinking of maybe contacting the honor societies of some of the high schools which have participated in our cleanups before. But conceivably, if some of the board members or some of the other volunteers in the village want to do that instead, I haven't made any commitments yet, so that's a possibility.
Okay.
I'll do this on the side.
well, please send out emails to the board if you do need, you know, I think we would like to get the schools notified regardless, not just the honor societies, but the schools aware of the event. You know, the high schools will be going back soon, all the schools will be going back soon, but the high schools go back first.
I have a question. Kathy, I know you probably sent the flyer to the, all the village clerks. What about the township?
Township, I can do that. If I can do that to the township.
Okay, appreciate it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're gonna move on to community relations. John Darrenowski.
So we are, our Facebook page is going very strong. We recently, about a week and a half ago, I posted about what George was talking about with Friday Lake County. And that post alone reached 155 people. So for us as a village, it's actually been very useful getting a lot of information out. Even the board meetings are seeing an increase. The last board meeting was up to 34 people watching the videos. So, you know, just loving the new tablet and loving the access that I have to see how things are going and progressing very quickly.
Okay. That's good. Let's move on. Jerry, of course, was excused. Public Safety, Trustee Nina Hyde.
We are going to start offering a safe gun lock that you can pick up at the village hall. It's being donated by the Grace Lake Police Department, and so I just have to figure out exactly if we want to keep them here for people to come and pick them up, or if the residents can email me and I can drop them off to their house. So we'll figure that out.
Is there anything in particular they have to fill out or do?
No, they don't have to fill anything out. Anybody's allowed to get it. You don't necessarily have to have a FOID card or anything like that. You don't have to show it to us.
The door is locked?
I'm sorry.
Oh,
okay.
Okay. Oh, wrong side.
Yeah. It's okay. It's available to anybody who, you know, wants to come and pick it up. So we just have to.
So do they need to be a Hainesville resident?
They don't have to prove it, but it's for our residents. The Grace Lake residents can go to their police department and pick it up.
Okay.
So
will they bring it here?
I pass them, and so we just need to determine later, not
keep it. So somebody could just come in and say, I would like to pick up, and so they can have up to how many?
They can have as many guns as they have, they can have as many locks as they'd like. So, but I just don't know if you guys want to house the locks here, or if we should have them email me, and I can bring them the locks. I just don't. It's not like you're not going to get 20 people coming up to your door.
No, but I think you'd want to keep them here.
As long as you guys have the room and don't mind it, and then once we run low, I can always
get more. Yeah. So then let's put a post on the website.
Yeah, so I have a
little article. And then an article in the newsletter for August.
And Facebook, yes.
Yes, and Facebook.
So when you decide where you want to put it, if you want to assume it, if you want them to email you, or if you want them to just come here.
They can do it either way. They can do it either way.
Yeah. Well, I can. It'll be easier if I just put one way residents have.
Okay, then they can come and pick it up.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so that's what we have.
And did you just want them to show their FOID card?
Nope, they don't need any proof of any ID to get it.
Okay.
I checked.
And does this lock, I'm going to stall with this.
Sure. It's a gun lock. It goes through the chamber of the gun.
Okay.
And stops it from firing. And then it'll be two keys.
Perfect.
So. That's that.
Okay.
That's all I have. And I'm not doing this, so we're not buying any time. The mayor gone, so somebody else can figure it out.
She's up next. They tried to get in the door over here.
Oh, I thought I saw something touch my eye.
The two of them tried to get in the door, and then it looked like he was.
It's been an exciting day. Okay, They actually are looking for the Round Lake Park Road trauma. They hate it. Okay, so I apologize. We finished up with Dina.
Yep, okay.
Okay, so we're all good. Moving on to administration, Kevin and I chatted briefly. He has sent me some emails with some pictures he's took. We haven't had a chance to meet though and sit down and talk about it.
No, I can do that later this week.
Yeah, okay.
Friday would be a good day for me if you're around.
Friday is not good because I have the LCTA meeting in Libertyville at 8 o'clock.
Friday afternoon?
Afternoon.
Okay, that's fine, Friday afternoon.
Let's confirm tomorrow and if not, then we'll do next week for sure.
That's fine.
Okay.
Before I go to Indiana.
Oh, you're partying in Indiana all next week?
A couple days.
Okay.
Typically, but they'll be Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Okay, all right. All right, so Friday or Monday, let's try to make that one. And then the only other thing I'll add at this point is that we're having a staff meeting tomorrow and it's been a while since we've had a full staff meeting. Want to go back to have them regularly and at this meeting we'll kind of be doing a A to Z or soup to nuts, if you will, overview of all the departments and the operations, talking about our new software, just trying to take an inventory, pat ourselves on the back for a lot of our good accomplishments and a lot of the hard work that we've done in the past year, and then also taking a look at what can be tweaked or what can be changed just to keep operations moving smoothly. And that's all I have. This time I'd like to ask for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Oh.
Public comment.
Hold the crowd back. We're going to have to get a phone line that YouTube can call in. Okay. Opposed? Meeting adjourned at 7:42.
Two.
Three. Whatever the clerk says goes.